don't have enough content.
For me, as this is
what's the secret
book. So,
when I first jumped into hacking, nobody gave me the med. Everyone kept saying, just start with the basics, play some CTFs, you will figure it out. But that's not enough. You need more than scattered tips. You need direction. This video is about giving you that direction. I will show you how to build the foundation that matters, the skills that compound, and the mindset that separates script keys from hunters who land real bounties. We are not talking about chasing low-hanging fruit. We are talking about understanding the bigger picture, how to learn faster, how to think deeper, and how to compress years of experience into months. So, this is AmrSec, go get your coffee ready, and let's dive in. So, the first thing you need to get straight. Imagine you are starting from zero, literally no knowledge at all. You can't just jump into bug bounty and start firing verb requests if you don't even know what a packet is or how Linux handles files or how simple commands like curl works. So, Linux and networking fundamentals are your entry ticket. Think of them as your alphabet before writing any story. Without them, everything else is just guessing. At the same time, you didn't need to become a sysadmin or network engineer, right? For example, understand what a 401 versus 403 really means. Know why 500 error is gold when you trigger it. Learn how requests, responses, and headers play together, because later, those tiny differences are exactly what will guide you to vulnerabilities. That's your foundation. Nothing flashy, but without it, you are just throwing payloads and praying. With it, you will actually read the app, not just poke at it. Once you have got all the fundamentals in place, the next step is clear. You need to actually see how the bugs work, not just read their names in a list. And the best place for that is Bortiswiger's Web Security Academy. Here is the deal. Every bug type that matters is there, with an exploitation, a lab, and a chance for you to break it with your own hands. SQL injection, XSS, SSRF, IDORs, they are all laid out like a training ground. Don't just skim the write-ups. Go into the labs, trigger the bug, fix it, and trigger it again. That's how you move from theory to NSTIC. Because later, when you are inside the real target, you won't be thinking, what payload should I Google? You already know how the vulnerability feels, where it hides, and why it works. That's where you stop being just a spectator and start being a hunter. Here's something a lot of people get wrong. You don't need paid course to start finding bugs. If anyone tells you that you must buy a course before you get into bug bounty, that's just not true. YouTube alone is a gold mine. Hunters like AmrSec and ton of other creators have already put out years of hard-earned experience for free. And they are not just showing up, they are walking you through how bugs actually work, how to think about them, and how to trigger them in real-world apps. Don't let the lens fool you either. A one-hour video is not a waste, it's a compressed knowledge. Every example, every step, every failure they are shared saves you a week of trial and error. With just YouTube, you can learn the bugs, understand why they work, and practice how to trigger them. No excuses, no gatekeeping. If you put the hours here, you are already be ahead of most hunters. Once you have got the basics and soaked up knowledge from YouTube, it's time to sharpen your skills with something more structured. That's where hackinghub.io comes in. Here is where things get really focused on bug bounty. Every boss is built around real-world findings with detected labs, tutorials, and step-by-step guides. You are not just learning theory. You are practicing techniques that hunters have actually used in the field. The platform pulls in content from creators like AmrSec, John Hammond, and others, but organizing it into a focused system designed to build a muscle memory. You will move from just understanding vulnerabilities to actually applying them with realism and precision. using labs modeled on real bug bounty reports. By that time, you will be already pulling off some small wins on public programs. That's cool, but now it is the time to step it up. The next move is private invites, and the fastest way to earn them is through Yes We Hack DOJO. Their monthly challenges are not toy labs. They are designed to mirror real-world bugs, the kind that sharpen your edge and actually count. Every challenge you solve is not just another flag. It's a step closer to a private target where the real action happens. Solve, submit, and you will start seeing those invites land in your dashboard. This is where game starts opening up. Once you are landing real bugs, highs, criticals, whatever, don't think the journey stops here. Bug bounty isn't a game you finish, it's a game you keep living up in. And here is the truth. Every single day is perfect time to learn something new. That's how you stay sharp, that's how you stay ahead. This is where the Critical Thinking Bug Bounty Bootcamp comes in. It's backed with advanced knowledge, insights, and techniques straight from experienced hunters. And the best part, you don't even need to sit down and watch. You can just listen on the go in the gym while you are hacking. Listening is good, but listening and absorbing a ton of real hunter knowledge, that's how you turn from successful bug bounty hunter into an unstoppable one. If you are that type who likes reading, books and reports together are one of the most deadliest combos you can add to your toolkit. Books give you structure, stuff like From Day Zero to Zero Day by Space Raccoon, or Bug Bounty Bootcamp break things down in clean ways so you understand not just what, but why. They are like your training manuals, frameworks you can always fall back on. But reports, man, reports are where the magic happens. Every single report you read is a real bug with a real technique that worked in the wild. Some hunters probably spent weeks or months grinding for that one idea to click, and you get to scope it up in 10-minute read. If you are pulling 3 solid techniques a day just from reports, imagine where you will be in a month. That's the real power. Books build your foundation, reports sharpen your play. One gives you the theory and the other gives you the proof. Mix both and you are basically hijacking years of other hunters' experience and is taking it into your own. At the end of the day, this whole journey is not about ticking boxes or memorizing payloads. It's about building a mindset, the ability to see what others miss, to think deeper than surface level scans, and to keep learning even when you already feel good enough. Bug bounty hunting is not a sprint, it's not even a marathon. It's more like lifestyle. Some days you will find nothing. Some days you will land the gold. But if you stick to the roadmap, keep stacking knowledge from labs, videos, communities, books, and reports, you will realize that you are no longer hunting bugs. You are sharpening yourself into someone who can outthink, outlearn, and outlast. So take these steps, make them yours, and never stop building, because the truth is simple. The hunters who keep learning are the ones who keep winning. So that's pretty much it. If you found this video helpful, do not forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more cybersecurity content. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments below, or you can reach me directly on Twitter. Until next time, stay curious and stay secure.